RTMP. What the heck is it? So if you're new to live streaming, or even if you've been streaming for a while, it's highly possible that you've heard of this concept called custom RTMP. Maybe you know that it's a way that you can actually do some really great things and stream just about anywhere. But still, what is RTMP? Maybe even you've been inside of a streaming software like ours here at StreamYard, and you see RTMP as an option for where you can stream. And again, what is this custom RTMP thing? Well, today, let's break it down. Hey, Mel here. So in this video, I'm actually gonna define what RTMP is. I'm gonna give you some examples about when you might wanna use it, and I'm also gonna show you how you can actually use StreamYard and broadcast to a custom RTMP destination. And of course, as always, a couple things to err on caution when using RTMP destinations. So now, as always, before we get started, I would love for you to make sure that you have subscribed to the StreamYard channel so that you don't miss our live broadcasts as well as tutorials such as this one. And don't forget to click that notification bell so you do get notified when we do create new content. Now let's start at the beginning. What does RTMP stand for? It stands for Real Time Messaging Protocol. Now we're not gonna get too technical in this video, but it is good to know enough to be dangerous. So really what this is it's a way to transmit audio, video, and data from one creating source to an output source. So a very easy, obvious example would be StreamYard is transmitting data, audio, and video to platforms such as Facebook, YouTube, LinkedIn, Twitch, and Twitter. Now, StreamYard actually makes this extremely easy where we don't even really need to worry about RTMP. However, there may be some situations where you want to actually stream your information and your audio and your video to a platform that's not already integrated with StreamYard. So those platforms I mentioned before are actually integrated with StreamYard. It makes it super easy. Again, we don't have to worry about any of it. But if you wanted to create a broadcast and stream it to, for example, Vimeo, or even Microsoft Teams, for example, there are live events inside Microsoft Teams. These are not currently integrated with StreamYard or even many other platforms. You can use custom RTMP and still use an application like StreamYard to create your show or your event or your interview and still be able to output it to these other places. Now, as I mentioned, StreamYard makes it extremely easy to create live broadcasts to the common social media platforms. But let's talk about a couple of examples of where you may want to actually create a broadcast and stream it somewhere else. So let's say you want to conduct a webinar. So you're going to be able to share your screen, present some slides, maybe even do some demonstrations. You want to be on screen as well. So you may actually want to have this displayed on a web page. Now you can use an application like Vimeo, which will allow you to embed that live broadcast inside Vimeo to a web page that might be gated with a password, or people need to register for your webinar where you're gonna send them a custom link to access this information, meaning the webinar. Now you can use the application StreamYard, which is incredible, easy for screen sharing, displaying yourself, toggling back and forth to conduct the webinar. You would use RTMP to stream it to Vimeo, and then you would use the embed code that Vimeo provides to you to put onto your website for your webinar to be displayed. Now, another example could be that you're hosting a live event inside of your business or your company, or you're using Microsoft Teams. Microsoft Teams will also allow you to use StreamYard to create an amazing production that would then be displayed inside of your Microsoft Teams event because you're using the RTMP function. So another example that's becoming very popular is Amazon Live. You can use StreamYard and the RTMP function to actually produce your show, produce your live stream that is going to be displayed on Amazon Live. Okay, you might be wondering at this point, Mel, why wouldn't I just use those applications to create the broadcast inside of those applications natively? Well, StreamYard has some features that you might want to consider that you might want to use that will help you create an amazing broadcast. For example, you can bring people into the video production as interviews. You can actually have a whole panel discussion. You can change and toggle the views of how those people in your panel look. You can share your screen. You can play videos inside of the stream natively from your computer, or you can even pre-upload them into StreamYard for ease. Now, there are other features and functions programs that you might want to be using from StreamYard to create an amazing experience, which is the whole reason why you may want to say, hey, I want to create this really great show inside StreamYard, but I want to stream it to this outside destination. Now, we've got a really great blog article that goes into a lot more technical detail about RTMP, what it is, about stream keys and all the things. So if you want to read more about those aspects, I would highly recommend you check it out. We'll make sure we have a link to that in the description. Now, next, I want to show you how to actually use the RTMP function with StreamYard. Okay, here we are inside of your StreamYard dashboard. Now, we're going to go to our destinations and we're going to be adding a new destination. Now you're gonna notice we have our integrated options already in here, but we also have the custom RTMP option. That's what we wanna select for this type of broadcast. Now you're gonna see here that you're gonna need a bit of information from your output platform. So you need your RTMP server URL and your stream key. So that might be actually the harder part for you to find inside of whatever platform it is, but always advise your help or service provider to find out this information. So all you're going to be doing is simply copying and pasting this information into these particular fields. Now you want to nickname your stream, your custom RTMP destination as well so that it's easy to locate it. So we're simply going to say add RTMP server and voila. And you're going to notice that when you go to create a broadcast, you're now going to see your new custom RTMP destination as an option. Now, one of the really great things about StreamYard as well is the multi-streaming features. You can actually select your custom RTMP destination as well as another destination, whether it be another custom RTMP destination or one of your integrated pages like a Facebook business page. And when you do that, it's gonna ask you to add your title and your description, and you can customize for each destination. When you're ready, you simply just click create broadcast and it's going to open up our streaming studio inside of StreamYard, where you're then going to follow all the other prompts to enter that broadcast studio. You can add yourself to the stream, and just like any other broadcast, you're going to simply click go live to start your live broadcast. And as you can see here, it's going to push to the Facebook business page I selected, as well as our custom RTMP destination. And as you can see, you get to use all of the great features inside of the StreamYard studio to create an amazing broadcast. Pretty cool, right? So you can use StreamYard and the RTMP as a destination, and it's super easy to use as you just saw. Now, there is something I want you to consider when you're thinking about using a custom RTMP destination. So you actually will not be able to see the chat or the comments on that platform that you're streaming to inside of the StreamYard studio. So if you're a StreamYard user, you already know that one of the best features of StreamYard is that even if you're multi-streaming across multiple platforms, you can see all of those comments from those integrated platforms right inside the studio. You can also display those comments, which I love to do to increase engagement. However, when you are streaming to a custom RTMP destination, such as Vimeo or Microsoft Teams event, and people are commenting inside that platform, you won't be able to see them. So you're gonna need to have that platform open in another web browser or perhaps on your phone. Now, another note to consider is that if you are multi-streaming to a Vimeo event, for example, and YouTube at the same time, and you're planning to display comments from those YouTube commenters, keep in mind that you will not be able to provide the same experience for the people watching over and chatting on Vimeo. So maybe consider a strategy when you're planning a multi-stream where you're gonna have an integrated social media platform and an RTMP. Well, there you have it. Now you know what RTMP is. You know enough to be dangerous, right? And of course, you have some reasons why you might want to consider using RTMP. And now you see how easy it is to actually create an amazing stream with RTMP and StreamYard together. So as always, don't forget to subscribe to our channel. We do not want you to miss any of our great content. Don't forget to click that notification bell as well so that you get notified when we upload new tutorials. And of course, when we go live, which is just about every single day. So what are some ways that you might be thinking about using custom RTMP for your live videos? We would love to know in the comments. Let us know down below.